Are you trying to decide whether you want to learn C++ or C#? Well, let me walk you through some of the differences in the next few minutes. Hi, my name is Chuck McCullough, and let's dive in.
One of the biggest differences between C++ and C# is in how code is organized among source files. In the case of C++, code is split between what we call header files and implementation files. The reason for that is that each source file compiles in isolation without any awareness of any other code. The header files contain declarations, not necessarily lines of code or algorithms, but the declarations so that the compiler can successfully match up your function calls with the function being called. In the case of C#, we have one-stop shopping. Declarations and implementation are in a single location in a single file. The C# compiler can see the content of other modules that have already been compiled because the C# compiler includes a lot of metadata in those compiled files. Now, some of the basics of C++ versus C#, they are both strongly typed. C++, however, is very static in the sense that the compiler strips away most of the original source code when it produces the machine code. If you were to decompile or reverse engineer the compiled code, you probably wouldn't end up with something that looked too much like the original source code, especially with an optimizing compiler. That means that there's a limited ability to dynamically load and execute code in C++. That's what we mean by static. Also, C++ is a value-based language. C#, on the other hand, also strongly typed, but it's dynamic. When the C# compiler converts source code, it leaves a lot of metadata, the method names, the class names, the parameter names, in that compiled code. That means that we can, through something called reflection, dynamically discover and generate even and execute code that was dynamically created and loaded into memory. Also, C# is a reference-based language. Now, the execution environment in C++, the source code is converted into machine code, as we mentioned. That machine code executes directly on your hardware, and the compiler oftentimes optimizes for a specific CPU. The programmer really needs to have a pretty good understanding of what computer programs look like when they're running on the actual machine. C#, on the other hand, is converted into a machine code, but not for a physical piece of hardware, for an intermediate machine, something we call a virtual machine. This particular virtual machine is known as the Common Language Runtime, or CLR. It is helpful still for the programmer to understand computer architecture, and C# is supervising or managing the execution, so you don't have to be quite as worried about a mistake that would cause a catastrophic result. In C++, as an object-oriented language, we can declare new data types using the keyword struct or the keyword class. We tend to use the keyword struct for defining data types, whereas we use the keyword class for the object-oriented class concept. C++ also allows us to create enumerated types. There are many ways in C# to define new types, struct and class, just like C++, but these are different in C#. A struct is used to define a value-based data type, similar to types in C++, while class is used to create the typical C# reference type. C# also supports interfaces, which are not directly supported in C++. We just use the keyword class there. C# also supports enums. And starting in C# version 9, there's a new type specifier called record that's very convenient for creating data transfer objects, for defining simple aggregates that are strongly typed still with a minimum syntax to use as parameters and return types from functions. A very key difference is that C++ programmers will allocate memory with new, but the programmer must explicitly free that memory with delete. Now, in C++, in modern C++, The usage of smart pointers and resource acquisition is initialization, or RAII, alleviate a lot of the explicit memory management, as well removes a very troublesome aspect from most of our source code, and that is called raw pointers. Raw pointers give programmers a lot of trouble. And so in modern C++, you'll still have pointers and you still have to do memory management, but not nearly as much as you had to in the old days. Now in C Sharp, the programmer still dynamically allocates memory with the keyword new, but garbage collector will free that memory for them. The good thing is that we don't have to worry so much about memory leaks. The downside is that the programmer has no control over garbage collection. So if it isn't quite as immediate as you had hoped, you have no way to change that behavior. Both C++ and C Sharp support generic programming. In C++, it's known as a template, and templates generate a new class for every variant of that template, a first class type. The result of that is something we call invariance. Now, there's also in programming something known as covariant and contravariant beyond the scope of this discussion, and C++ supports those concepts through the use of conversion operators. In C Sharp, generics are known as generics, essentially the same syntax as templates in C++, and they are invariant by default, as C Sharp also generates a new type for each generic variant that is specified in code, much the same as C++. C Sharp, however, has keywords that can be used to control whether it is invariant, covariant, or contravariant. Both languages also support functional programming. In C++, basically inherited from the C programming language, a variable can hold a pointer to a function that can be used to call the function indirectly. And starting in C++ version 11, we can specify lambda expressions to generate anonymous functions or functor classes on the fly as inline code. C Sharp formalized the concept of a function pointer a little bit over C++ with something known as a delegate. And in C Sharp, we also have lambda expressions that can be used to generate anonymous delegates as inline code. Both C++ and C Sharp are object-oriented programming languages, or at least support object orientation, and therefore support inheritance. C++ supports multiple inheritance, meaning that a class can have multiple distinct base classes. Now, most project leads and architects would bristle at the idea of multiple inheritance. So even in C++, we tend to try to limit the inheritance to a single class and use the multiple inheritance to implement multiple interfaces. Because there's not a specific interface syntax, syntactically it looks like multiple inheritance, but we'll assume that all of the classes that we quote-unquote inherit from are actually interfaces and not classes. Polymorphism is implemented essentially at compile time through the clever use of function pointers, so that at runtime, we're only one extra assembly language or a couple of extra assembly language statements away from actually making the same call that you would make statically in a non-polymorphic environment. Now, C Sharp supports only single inheritance, and the root of all of the classes in C Sharp is an object type. It does have a specific syntax for interfaces, and a C Sharp class can implement multiple interfaces. Polymorphism in C Sharp is accomplished through dynamic binding by the runtime mechanism. So it's a little different mechanism, but again, performance is still pretty good. Now, the libraries for C++ and C Sharp are quite distinctly different. C++ supports the basic stuff that all programs would basically need: dates and times, collections, utilities, and as of version 11, threads and tasks, as well as I/O. The C++ library is pretty rich, but doesn't include by default things like user interface libraries and other specialized libraries. They are available, but just not part of the standard library. In C Sharp, you get everything that's in the C++ standard library, plus several different GUI APIs for developing desktop applications, as well as a framework, ASP.NET, for web development, and a whole connectivity, a whole API for database connectivity, including an object relational mapper known as Entity Framework. Much broader, more encompassing library in .NET for C Sharp.
Now, certainly C++ has a longer learning curve, and a successful C++ developer will need to have some understanding of how software executes on the hardware. In exchange for this, though, you will have blazing fast performance. C++ is best for computationally intensive applications like simulations and games, as well as embedded systems like in automotive or telecommunications. C Sharp, on the other hand, was designed to be easier to learn than C++. So clearly it has a shorter learning curve. However, it is a much larger language with a vastly larger library. C Sharp is better suited for applications with user interfaces, like web applications and desktop applications. Hey, I'm Chuck McCullough, and I hope you enjoyed this presentation. Check out our other videos in this channel, as well as our other courses listed in the description below.